look what I found.
Shout out to the person who sent me this a year ago or something. I just got into smoothies again with a bunch of spinach and stuff because it's a really easy way to get your vegetables in. And today I found this big boy, so now we can make even bigger smoothies. And then the rush. I just buy like fruit smoothie kind of thing from the supermarket, and then I just add a bunch of vegetables, in this case spinach. I also added a little bit of quark for them protons and for like a little bit of that thickness. I know y'all like that thickness, so gotta add that in. And it just really fills you up. Tons of micros to make you feel good, because let's be honest guys, we can all be shredded and stuff, but if you don't feel good, then what's the point? God damn, that's good. Now that we're talking about feeling good. Hey boy. There is a new flavor of brandzaak. This one is from Cuba and I have already tasted it. As you can see, like the label is broke. I'm not gonna lie to you guys. And it's freaking delicious. So we're gonna make a nice little new cup again today. It's like a freaking science thing up in here. We all want consistency in our lives, right? That is why you use your scale with everything, use a timer, and most importantly, you write that shit down. This is my little coffee book. I write all my recipes and stuff down, all my variables, and then I also write down like how the coffee was and stuff. And then if I have like a perfect cup, then I can just replicate that because I know all the variables. Talking about variables, shout out to the person whose name didn't want to be named for getting me this freaking sick ass kettle. I can like do really, really precise pour overs with this bad boy, and I can set the temperature. So that's also another variable that is just bam, consistent now. Consistency point!
We're gonna put that on 88 degrees.
Generally, if you want to extract more coffee, you can do that by A, grinding it a little bit finer. B, you can use hotter water. C, like have a longer steep time, which isn't really that relevant with this one because the water just pours through here. But if you're using an aeropress, if you're using, for example, a French press or an aeropress, then that's also a variable you need to take into consideration. And then obviously your coffee to water ratio, but that doesn't really change the extraction. It just changes like how strong you want your coffee. So we grinding away, and this, it has all the variables I need. So it has the grams of coffee on what setting it's grinded, it's how much water, and the degrees of water. And then I just also time like how much water I pour in within the first, in this case, 45 seconds. And then, yeah, I just write every single thing down, and then eventually you will get your perfect cup. Because there is not a single perfect cup. It's gonna be your perfect cup. Everybody has a different taste. I personally really like a light roast, like a really fruity coffee.
You just like change so much with every single coffee. So yeah, there are so many variables and so many types of things you can taste, and it's just gonna be your perfect cup. And if you like really keep track of all the variables that you're doing, then you can just like fine tune the exact things that you like, and then it's just gonna be so cool. We done grinding.
Probably the next investment in my coffee is gonna be a new grinder to get a more consistent grind. Haha, there we have the consistency again. I'm gonna explain you.
Okay. So this is our ground up coffee. You want all of these particles to pretty much be exactly the same size. So if we grab a few here, we actually want all of them to be exactly the same size. But as you can see, there are a few ones that are a little bit bigger, and then also a few ones that are like really small. And what you want is just the, let's say you want to extract this amount. So water goes in here, 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 and it gets through here. You want to extract all of this. But you don't want to extract this. Because this is like bitter and stuff. When water comes in here and this one, it actually goes way faster to the middle because the particle is smaller. So you want consistency in your life, consistency in your grind. So I write all of these variables down so that if by some chance this is gonna be my perfect cup, then I can just replicate it and have my perfect cup on every single day. We want to swirl this a little bit because in the bottom the coffee is gonna be stronger than in the top. This is actually gonna be a good cup. You can use a metal filter, but what you can also do is using this with a paper filter in it. What this will give you is a cleaner cup, so more fruity notes. This will give you a more bold cup. This bean is also a little bit more like creamy or something. So with this one, I'd like to use a metal filter over a paper filter. But with the Ethiopia, you definitely just want to use a paper filter or just something that just gets rid of oils and things that will make the cup less clean. Oh, this is good though. It's definitely like a different feel, metal filter over a paper filter. You will get more, you will get like a fuller bodied coffee. Woo! Yeah, boy! Boys, you all know, now you might not know, but I really do enjoy still watching professional League of Legends. I don't really play anymore, no, I literally haven't played in 2 months. But I still like watching professional play. This is the final from the Chinese League, and it's like really interesting and how they play, and just I just like how professional it is, like from everything, just The whole scene, the whole esports scene and stuff, it's just so interesting how it just can like emerge out of nothing and how many people get jobs from like a new industry and stuff. Like, that's so cool. For example, what was this guy doing 5 years ago? Now he has a job in esports, man. That's freaking, I don't know, man. It just really hypes me. I could talk about this for years. Just like how I can talk about coffee for years.
Hey guys! I'm back again. Did you miss me?
I'm sure you did.
As you may or may not have noticed or heard, I have my big boy camera in my hand, and let me fix this a little bit. A little bit more headspace now? Yeah, we do. Hell yeah, we do. I feel really productive today. Like, I've been doing stupid stuff like mailing people, and now I feel like a god. But the reason why you are now watching my face on the ugly camera is because in here is a lens, a 8mm lens, and it is freaking hype. I'm gonna put it on my big boy camera, and now because I filmed with this one, I couldn't film with that one because I have to put stuff on there. I'm very professionally opening this thing, as you can see. But first, let me show you something. Alright guys, so what you are seeing now is a 30mm lens, so it's very zoomed in. We're gonna switch to 18mm. You can see this is a lot wider already. This is 18mm, this is pretty much the standard focal length, which most cameras and also phones use. Now, poo! Even more range, so this is 10mm. This is like the widest I can get, and I really like this view for vlogging and stuff, because you can see so much around me. If I hold my camera like this, like, you can see a lot. But now we have this bad boy, and you are gonna see even more. Time to remove the cap and see how much we can see. Let's see, boys. Holy fuck. That's crazy, man. Look at that view, man. That's fucking insane, dude.
So the thing with this lens is it's manual focus, so I probably need to do a little bit of this before I am in focus. But because it's so wide, pretty much everything is in focus. Also, one thing that is really great about this lens, it's a f to f2.8 aperture. That means it will get a lot of light in there. Also can still give you a little bit of that blurry background if you go really into something.
So this is when I have to focus as close as possible, and this is when I have to focus like as far as possible. As you can see, it doesn't really make that much of a difference. So for me, it's not really a problem that it's a manual lens.
But for real, man, this thing is freaking sick. You can see so much, and you can do so much creative shots with this. And I'm just so excited to take this one to the gym and like make some cool pictures with it, make some cool video with it. That's pretty much it. But I think this might actually become like my new just walk around style vlogging lens.
So this is what the vlogs might start to look like. It definitely is a little bit distorted. I might be able to fix that in post, and I might not be able to. But I really like this as like a vlogging lens because you can just see so much. Like, you guys might have the feeling that you are actually here now because you can see so much. So definitely let me know what you think about this lens, if you really like this look, if you freaking hate it.
Okay, guys, so we have one more thing. Kaboosh. A Prakash from my boy Mino. I am excited as that was one smooth ass unpacking, boys.
Oh my god, what's this gonna be?
Holy fuck! Oh my gosh! Fuck drone, dude! You crazy? I want to play with this now, but I'm not gonna. Because first, there isn't any time left in this vlog. Am I gonna unpack this? Or am I gonna do this tomorrow? I'm gonna do that tomorrow. I want to thank you guys for watching this video. Tomorrow! You will see me being freaking hyped as
also in tomorrow's vlog. Well, probably not gonna be tomorrow's vlog, but pretty soon. I am gonna do something that I've been procrastinating with a reason for the entire winter. It's gonna be tomorrow's gonna be freaking hype, boys. I'm so excited. I hope you are as excited as I am. I hope this vlog. I hope you guys like this vlog, this non-gymnastics vlog. Update on my neck. It's alright, it's not the best, so that's why there was no gymnastics in this video. I still hope you liked it. Yeah. Be excited, please, for the next video. And be content with this video. Oh my god, this is gonna be a sick week. Alright, see you later, boys. Peace!